In the previous video, I showed subtraction on the number line, but I didn't use a rule that I gave in two videos ago. I actually showed subtraction, but I think in practice you'll find it easier to use the rule than to try to actually try to subtract negative numbers. So I want to go through these examples again, doing it by the rule. Now, we start out with this. Question here. Get my pencil. 4 subtract positive 7, and I said in the rule, you keep the first number as it is. You change to subtract to add, and you change the sign of the second number. So this now becomes an addition of positive 4 and adding negative 7. So again, we start at the origin. We go 4 in the positive direction, and we are now adding. We're not subtracting anymore, we are adding, but what we're adding is a negative 7. And when you add a negative 7, it goes 7 in the negative direction. That's just the same as subtracting a positive number. Let's go to the next one. Now this is the kind of question that really helps to use the rule, because it can be kind of mind-bending trying to figure out subtracting a negative number. But you just take and you rewrite the initial number as it is. You change subtraction to the adding, and you change the sign on the second number, and that was a minus 7, so it becomes a plus 7. And so we start out here, always start at the origin. We go 4 in the positive direction, and now we're going to add 7. I'm going to write it underneath here. I'm going to add positive 7. That goes another 7 in the positive direction. Adding a positive 7 is the same as subtracting a negative 7. And with all these minus signs here, it gets a bit confusing, so I just change them both to plus, and it becomes a nice simple 4 plus 7. Okay, this next question, we have a negative 4. You always keep the first number as it is. You don't change the sign on the first one. You change the operation from subtraction to addition, and you change the sign on the second number. Now you can see we're adding two negative numbers, and you know that they both go in the same direction, and we're just going to end up with minus 11. So we start out at 0, and we go 4 in the negative direction, and now we are going to add negative 7, meaning we continue going another 7 in the negative direction. Now, subtracting a positive number is the same as adding a negative number. That might make sense. That might not be so confusing. It's not like when you're trying to do a negative of a negative, that gets a bit confusing. But here, adding a negative and subtracting a positive, it looks just about the same. Now here, our final example, we have 4 subtract negative 7. I'm going to rewrite the first number as it is, and then you change the subtraction to adding, change the sign on the second number, and then it becomes negative 4. Add a positive 7. So start at 0, and we go 4 in the negative direction, and we're supposed to add a positive 7. That means we go 7 in the positive direction from here, and we end up at positive 3. And we change both of those signs to pluses, and that's how it works. So hope this makes a little bit more sense now. I'm going to make yet another video on subtracting negative numbers with a different way of looking at subtraction. In this case, we did what we did as takeaway, and I have another way of showing subtraction, which I call the difference, and I'll do that in another video.